life and faith, the life and grace, the ancient Hebrews, the prophets, the gospel writers, and the early Christians. God even worked through those who didn't even know him, like Cyrus in Isaiah 45:4. I read this quote the other day. It said, "The Bible is the only book that you can never finish. It's alive. You see new things each time you study it." I can attest to that. There's times that I've read through the Bible several times, and then all of a sudden something really comes out to me. It lights up different things in my life. God speaks to us today through all Scripture. 2 Timothy 3:16 and 17 tells us, "All Scripture is God-breathed, is useful for teaching, rebuking, correcting, training in righteousness, so that the servant of God may be thoroughly equipped for every good work." He also speaks to us through the church, through our sermons, Bible studies, general fellowships, and prayer groups, as well as other authors in Christian-based books and devotionals. We have Bible studies here in our church and in the area of churches around. They're taught by responsible teachers, as well as library information, audio and video resources, and other resources you possibly get from the church. I just want you to know one thing. The Bible is intended to bring understanding, not conflict. Two of you can read the same scripture and come up with different ideas. It doesn't mean you have to argue over it. Talk about it. Talk to you. If you don't agree with somebody, talk to them. Just don't let it be a controversial issue. We need to live in Christ, live in peace with each other. The Bible study I use, first of all, I start with prayer. Always pray before you do anything. And I pray that God will reveal to me what he wants me to learn that day. Then I find a comfortable spot, but not too comfortable. I can fall asleep easy. I get up early in the morning when it's quiet in the house. I read my Bible and my devotional. I spend an hour and a half every morning just reading what's quiet in the house. It's amazing how awesome it is. If you're a first-time reader of the Bible, I recommend you start with the New Testament. Start with the Gospels. Read the Gospels first and move through. What I do is I take my study Bible, which is an NIV study Bible. I read one verse in the Bible, but I don't read the notes. I just read the scripture itself. Then I grab a different translation of the Bible, maybe the NLT or the Message or ASV, American Standard. And I read that same scripture again, or read the same chapter again. Then I turn around and I grab my study Bible back again, and I read it again. So I read that same thing three times in a row. By doing this, I get a better perspective of what is being said. And as I do it, the third time, I read the notes to go with it, kind of put everything in perspective. This gives me an awesome perspective of what's being said. So the question I ask you at first, like, I don't understand what I am reading or studying. Well, I have trouble reading, understanding what I read. I can read something and just go right over my head. I don't get it. I have to read it two or three times sometimes. But I make my will, I'm going to do this. I'm going to read this. I'm going to read it. I'm going to read it and understand it. I don't like to read or study. Well, if you can't understand it, you have a tendency not to want to read it. I don't know what to read or study. Well, I've answered that one, the Bible. I don't have time to study or read. Well, it's more like I don't take time sometimes. I've tried to get over that one as well. After Jesus got my attention, I became very interested in who Jesus was. I was able to overcome my problems. I made time to read. I actually like to read now. The key is centering our lives on Christ and grounding ourselves in His Word. Learn daily about our Savior. Study the Bible. Develop your theological knowledge. Stay humble and curious about the amazing complexity of the world God has made. Ask a lot of questions about assumptions behind ideas that you do not know. Press toward wisdom. Pray for understanding. God has given us a mind to learn. Don't stop using it. In conclusion, the knowledge of God's love for us kindles a lifelong commitment to discover more about the person of Jesus in order to put on the mind of Christ. Life is a pilgrimage into the presence of God's perfect love. Jesus accompanies on that journey, whether we know him or not. Thank you.
Thanks, Ed. Thanks, Ken. Thanks, Red. Thanks, Damien, for leading our service today. Good job, guys. So let's stand for our final hymn this morning.
Sang part of this song. And every time I sing this, I cry. Because it means a lot to me. He lives. He lives. God lives for us. My prayer for you today is that he lives in your life, that you follow him. Let him lead you. Open your hearts to him. And God, I pray. Amen.
Amen.